Software Engineering Introduction. Bjorn Straustrup, the creator of the C++ programming language, once said that our civilization runs on software. This statement is backed by reality. Software controls a massive variety of devices, from cell phones and music players to smart appliances such as microwave ovens and laundry machines to personal computers. Devices that many people use at work and large mainframe computers operate in governmental organizations. In fact, it is hard to imagine an area of human activity that does not rely at least partially on software, including professional work, home activities, and entertainment. In this series, we will learn the tools and methods that we need to apply to everything we work on while building our software. We'll discuss everything according to the CIWI book, or the Software Engineering Book of Knowledge. The CIWI book has 12 areas of knowledge: requirements, design, coding or construction, testing, quality, process, tools and methods, configuration management, maintenance, project management, and economics. The 12th form of knowledge is professional practice, which is about the code of ethics and morals to acquire as software engineers. I believe there will be around 8 to 10 courses, 3 to 7 hours each. To benefit the most from this course, I want you to visualize every situation and discuss several solutions. Don't think only about your company and the way your company usually does its work. Your company might do something one way, and it is working fine. We are here to learn about other companies and all kinds of projects of different sizes and domains. So please, be open-minded to accept new ideas. For example, while watching this course, I want you to visualize a big company with hundreds of software practitioners from every field working on a single project or product line. I want you to imagine yourself dealing with others in a work environment, whatever your role is. By the end of the series, you should learn each software-related character's role: developer, tester, designer, manager. What problems they may face, how to solve them, what should we expect from them, and what they're expecting from us. What are their best practices, tools, and techniques? How do we know if they are doing a good job or not? Can we measure the quality of their work? We will learn the language they use, so communication will be more comfortable working with them. For example, the project manager's vocabulary includes charter, crashing. The designer's vocabulary includes coupling, design patterns. The developer's vocabulary includes bugs, debugging, build making, and many more. Speaking of bugs, a developer was on his first date with a girl who was not from the software industry. He started talking about a tough bug that didn't make him sleep the other night. The look on that girl's face was priceless, as she doesn't understand what kind of insect or bug can do that. It will be hard for the project manager to understand the terms or phrases a developer uses. But suppose the manager understands the language of the developer. In that case, it will save us a lot of time and effort to work closely with each other. The same thing can be said regarding every role in the software industry. It is also good to mention that each course here sets the ground to learn about a new software engineering practice. I mean that, for example, you will not be an analyst after taking the software requirements course, but I promise you will be ready to take the next step towards any advanced software engineering topic much easier. Honestly, in my case, learning software engineering alone with practical experience helped me pass many certifications with minimum effort. I remember there was a significant discount to attend a software test management exam in my country. So I decided to take the exam just 2 days before the exam due date. I didn't have much time to study, but it was a big discount, worth the risk. And I made it. Passed the exam with just my general knowledge about software engineering and project management. And I believe you can do that as well after taking my courses.